Welcome back, my legion, to Let's Play Banjo-Tooie. Now, we are in Jolly Roger's Lagoon, and oddly enough, we will be entering the actual lagoon this time. I did tease that in the last part, mostly because I completely forgot about that Cheeto page thing. However, now, we're actually diving under, and as you can see, Mumbo Magic did actually work. Unlike, a lot of things. These sea anemones, however, do need a little bit of help. What you want to do is you want to shoot them in the eyes to completely disable them for a small amount of time. These things are basically immortal and will injure you. So you want to just disable them so you can get the lovely little specks and stuff inside. Otherwise, this is going to happen. Now, there is a way to cheat this, but we don't have the move yet. And yes, you have to hit them in their eye, not in their surrounding protective area, because I've had that happen several times. And the best way in swimming, or the best way that I can find to swim in Jolly Roger's Lagoon is, honestly, like this. It gives you the best control and the best move around when you're just first-person camming through this entire area. So anybody with a sensitive stomach that tends to not be able to focus very well in a first-person perspective, sorry. But let's move on to the next area, shall we? Welcome to Atlantis, an actual place in Banjo-Kazooie. Is anyone even remotely surprised? This is where Jolly Roger's Lagoon actually starts to make a little bit more sense and become a lot more difficult. Mostly because we start running into enemies that we can't fight well right now. The pufferfish. The pufferfish can only be taken out with either a grenade egg or a move, again, that we don't have, which we should be picking up relatively soon. And it might be in here. I can't remember if this is that move or not, but I guess we'll see. The Electric Eel's den is literally just here for jam jars, which is up the stairs. Alright, so yes, this was the move I was thinking of. The Talon Torpedo. I'll be demonstrating that once I'm back outside, and yes, the electric eels will hurt you if you're not careful. But they are fairly easy to avoid. Now that I'm out here, let's demonstrate the Talon Torpedo. Or I can completely ignore that and continue moving on. Alright, so where am I going next? Ah, here we go. This is the Talon Torpedo. And another one that pilots a little bit better in first person. If you can collide with the pufferfish, they will completely disappear, at least until they respawn. And with the Talon Torpedo, I believe you can also maneuver into the sea urchin or sea anemones without actually getting hurt. Don't quote me on that though, I cannot remember from the top of my head. And this move is important to get a couple of very secret passages, I would say that they are. Outside of Jolly Roger's Lagoon. And yes, in order to get past the octopuses, you do need the ice eggs to freeze them. Well, I say do. In theory, you could avoid the tentacles, but God, is that annoying. Also, be very careful when swimming and firing grenade eggs. You may run into your own bullets. Or explosions, I guess. And let's line it up. Since I know that we need... I guess we'll come back and do this later. Because there is a warp pad right here for some odd reason. And yes, I know. That's the odd thing about the swimming mechanics. You can accidentally activate a warp pad if you're not careful. So, what I meant by secret passages is areas like this. You see Kazooie's face on this grate right here. In order to break it, you need the Talon Torpedo. And you need to hit it at a decent speed. But let's go ahead and warp back to town real fast. Because now that we have Talon Torpedo, we can head into this area and collect a few things that are just laying about. Since there is a basement down here, which leads us to... the smuggler's cabin. Which demonstrates the other ability of the Talon Torpedo, which is not getting any easier to say, no. If you see these transparent fish right here, you will notice that they have items inside of them. These items range from notes, feathers, Cheeto pages, and a jiggy. You have to find literally all of these things in order to get all of the rewards. As odd as that sounds. And I would highly suggest breaking open all the grates with Kazooie's face on them if for no other reason than, well, it makes life a little bit easier when trying to figure out exactly what you've missed and what you still have to do. Oh good, this is Grundy Industries. So you just want to swing through these pipes and hit the fans with the ice eggs and make sure not to hit the blades because, of course, that will damage you. Heading into Grundy Industries, what are we doing in Grundy Industries? I've completely forgotten. Oh yeah, it's just a Jinjo for Grundy Industries that you can only access through Jolly Roger's Lagoon. And of course, it's only through the Smuggler's Den that you can access that area. So clearly there's some implications about Grundy Industries not only being massive polluters, but stealing things from other people. Are we not quite done painting Gruntilda as the villain of this series? But let's see, is there anything else that we can do in here? Currently, because I know there's one thing we can't do until we go to level 7. Yeah, Freezy Pink is level 7. Wait, what's level 8? I can't remember. But that pathway will lead you back to this area, just, you know, to show that everything is indeed connected. And yeah, I didn't bring this up before, but that is totally a crashed UFO. And we will be heading inside of said crashed UFO. Because, of course, it's a landmark, and in every landmark, there is at least something important. In this case, aliens and a Jiggy. That's not a Jinjo. Is ice not crystallized? Also, how are you getting power out of ice? Seriously, this is bothering me, and yes, they do all say the same thing. So I suppose we'll have to help you get your ice, which you can easily do by standing in the middle of the room. Stand in the middle and just rotate either left or right while aiming for the center of the glowing circles there. Once you fire all four eggs, this happens. And now to see what they say now that we have saved their lives. Seriously? You ungrateful! That's all you're gonna say. Well, okay, I'll forgive you because of the interesting animations you guys have. Also, yeah, you can have the Minjo. I really don't care if that drowns or not. Also, how did the Minjo get on the ship? Wait, were you going to... Speaking of World 7, but yes, these strange aliens flew away and totally left us a Jiggy that they landed on. I'm cool with that. And yeah, while the octopus tentacles don't hurt you when he's frozen, they do still stun you, which is a tad bit annoying, but, you know, regardless, whatever. Okay, so there's that door. And... right, okay, so this Jiggy's gonna be practically impossible. Before we do anything, what we want to do is head over to this door and notice the Greek symbols that are on it. these are the code you need to memorize, and if I remember right, it is randomized for every save file. You want to take note of the four statues here, and you want to shoot an egg into each one that, is it a nice egg? Well, you need to shoot an egg. I can't remember if it's specifically an ice egg or not. But the point being is that you're going to want to use eggs that you're not going to miss. And once you enter the code, the door opens, and we will be headed in there and dealing with that particular jiggy next time on Let's Play Banjo-Tooie. Later, my legion.